scriptures and the Chinese classics, between Jewish tradition and the Chinese tradition. As a result, Jewish tradition was never an integrated part of Chinese tradition or Chinese culture. It has remained foreign and somewhat mystical to Chinese people all the time. Compared with the success of Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam, which all entered China as alien traditions but became inseparable parts of Chinese culture later, the failure of the Jewish tradition to become a part of Chinese culture was both apparent and significant. Therefore, the point is not how we should introduce Jewish people and culture to China as if importing some foreign merchandises, but rather how we integrate Jewish tradition into Chinese culture so that it will work inside Chinese culture for the benefit of both Chinese people and the Jewish people. The answers to these questions of strategies by which to reach this purpose can be found in the wisdom of our forefathers. At the beginning of the Pirkei Avot and Confucius Analects, both the men of the Great Assembly and Confucius presented three basic strategies for establishing and perfecting a tradition. They are to safeguard the traditional classics, to build a successful master-disciple relationship, and to perfect the personal and intellectual qualities of the leaders of the tradition. While the man of the Great Assembly called for making a fence for the Torah, Confucius believed that a fence is to learn the traditional classics with constant perseverance and application. While the men of the Great Assembly encouraged raising up many disciples, Confucius stated that fellow students coming from afar were a great joy of life. While the men of the Great Assembly stressed the value of being deliberating in judgment, Confucius described a man of complete virtue as someone who feels no discomposure though men may take no note of him. To put into practice our forefathers' wisdom, I believe that there are three basic strategies to reach to our purpose. The first strategy is to bring the Jewish texts, both classic Jewish scriptures and modern Israeli literatures, to China. This means a major project for translating the main Jewish texts into Chinese language must be established and implemented. The second strategy is to teach this text to the Chinese people. This strategy includes various activities such as promoting the translated text, establishing relevant courses in educational institutes in China, etc. The third strategy is to raise and to support a group of leaders of Jewish tradition in China. This group of leaders is the most crucial factor to our success. Not only must they lead and implement the two above-mentioned strategies, but also they must reinterpret the translated text through their studies in order to find out how Jewish tradition can become acceptable to Chinese civilization and how it can contribute to Chinese culture. The history of Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam in China has shown that unless a foreign tradition can be reintegrated with Confucianism conceptions, and can hardly be integrated into Chinese tradition. My activities in the last decade were basically guided by these three strategies that were inspired by the wisdom of our forefathers. I dedicated myself to translation of Mishnaic and Talmudic texts into Chinese. My translation of Pirkei Avot was published in China in 1996, and that was the first time a complete Mishnaic tractate was published in China, in Chinese. Currently, I'm translating the Mishnah into Chinese, which is a project that I plan to finish in 10 to 15 years. Back to some 2,500 years ago, when Confucius said that he did not feel his composure, though man might take no note of him, he was probably summarizing his failure to recruit support for his tradition during his lifetime. We should not let this kind of lack of support happen to our group of leaders today. Therefore, I'm appealing to all of you, don't leave them alone. Support them spiritually, intellectually, and financially. I hope that in a few decades, when our descendants examined the friendship between our two peoples, they will find a more solid foundation and will say that this foundation started in our times. Thank you.